It's the middle of a very lovely spring, and if you're like me and you have children, you're probably wondering, or maybe worrying, what they'll be doing this summer. Well, joining me to discuss some great offerings are Levi Folley and Jennifer Himes. Jennifer, let's start with you. What's new?
We have two new programs this summer. One of them is the Elementary Institute for the Arts. It's a two-week program from July 13th through July 27th, and it's open to students who are currently in third, fourth, and fifth grade. And we will be offering several classes in the arts, rotating through dance, drama, music, and visual arts.
So you cover the gamut with the Institute?
All the arts,
and,
yes.
And where is it?
Lake Braddock Secondary.
Oh, so it's central. Mm-hmm. Most people can get there.
Mm-hmm. And we offer transportation from local high schools.
Expensive or?
Not very. About $450.
Per student for two full weeks.
For 2 weeks.
That's very reasonable. Good. All right, how about your front?
Sure, the second program Jennifer referred to is the STEM Camp, and that too will be at Lake Braddock.
Remind the audience, STEM is?
Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math, and that'll be at Lake Braddock as well, and that's about $325, I think, the tuition is, and that's a one-week course.
It's a one-week course.
And students will get a chance to explore new careers and new technologies. So we're excited about that.
Give us some examples. What types of things are kids doing?
Robotics, working with computers a lot, and building automobiles.
Okay. Now, both of these are enrichment, and why is that important? Why don't you start, Jennifer?
Well, what we try to focus on in these programs are classes, offering classes that students don't normally get during the regular school year. So it's something they can look forward to coming to. They enjoy it. We attract students who are heavily into these kinds of programs, and they don't have homework. You know, and they are with like-minded, they don't have homework, and they are with like-minded students who are all having a good time.
Great. So this is a I want to go kind of place.
Yes.
And the kids who tend to go are
come
all,
back all the time.
They do. So
they're very popular.
Same situation over at the tech camp? Same?
Yes, very much
same
so.
Same audience?
A lot of repeat kids year to year.
Okay. Yeah. Start with the older kids now. What are the offerings there?
For the academic program or the enrichment program?
Enrichment.
Okay, we have the full-blown Institute for the Arts, which is Jennifer's program. Mm-hmm. She'll talk about that in just a minute. But that too, like the elementary version, exposes students to art, various areas within the arts, music, dance, theater, and other things.
Mm-hmm. Anything you want to add to that, Jennifer?
Well, our Institute for the Arts is now in its 27th year. And it is a four-week program, so it runs from July 9th through August 3rd. And it is open to students who are currently in 6th through 11th grades.
Right. Now, I've actually been to the older Students Institute for the Arts, and it's a very impressive program. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember seeing kids doing some cartoon artwork.
Cartooning.
All the way to stage theater where,
stage combat.
Yeah, stage combat, all kinds of great things.
Yeah.
Good program.
Yeah.
All right, on the academic side then.
Well, we have two options through which students can earn credit during the summer. We have the term Graduate Academy, again at Lake Braddock Secondary School, and that's a program for our seniors about to graduate in August to come and complete one course so that indeed they can graduate in August. Most of our academic courses will be through the online campus program, which continues to grow, and students can earn credit in terms of credit recovery courses which they need to repeat, as well as if they want to get ahead. One portion of that program we're really excited about is how we're going to teach algebra and biology this summer. In the past few years, it's just been online. This year, it's going to be a blended environment where students will be at Lake Braddock for part of the time and take it online for the part of the time. So we're excited to see what the results of that's going to be.
And why the change?
When we looked at the performance of the students in the past, we felt we wanted to give them a little better chance at being successful, and research says this is the way to do it, so we're going to give it a try.
Jennifer, I have a 15-year-old with a learner's permit.
Mm-hmm.
Summer's also a time for driving.
I'm sorry.
It's scary.
Yes.
They're new, and you can really tell. It's just experience, isn't it?
Yes. And our adult and community education is offering a behind-the-wheel driver's education course this summer.
And if people want to learn more about that?
They can go to our public website and navigate to ACE.
Okay. I want to give our audience just some basic information about all of this stuff, because we've thrown a couple places to find information, but there's really one site, isn't there?
Our public website.
And just to navigate, give us some keywords.
If you go to our public website, www.fcps.edu, right on the front page, you can see summer programs and that will take you to everything that we've been talking about.
Great. Well, they both sound like excellent programs and great for kids. Thank you both for coming.
Thank you.
You're welcome.